Hello everyone, in this video you will learn that assigning your subdomain to your website in GetResponse isn't complicated at all. Let's now dive into it. We are currently in the dashboard and the first step to take is actually to go to the website builder itself. We will go here, Tools, Website Builder. You can now see that I have a few websites here and we will take one of them as an example. Let's go to the pre-designed 17, you just click on the website itself and connect a domain you own. In this video, this will be actually a subdomain. And it's as simple as clicking add a new domain here, and you will write the subdomain here. And subdomains look like this. Let me show you. So in this case, my subdomain will be called gelato, and then simple setup.xyz is my domain. And let's say that I'm using this domain for a different website hosted somewhere else. That's why I want a subdomain in GetResponse, so that I don't lose access to this website. And now just click add. All right, now we are in this page here, and the important part is that you copy the CNAME here. So you need to copy that, click got it. And now we need to go to our domain provider. We are using GoDaddy for this video, but if you have a different provider, it doesn't really matter. The point here is that you can access the DNS settings so that you can configure the subdomain. And if you are using GoDaddy as well, you can go to My Account, Manage Products, and you will be exactly in this page. Let's find now my domain, and it is simplesetup.xyz. Let's click DNS, and you'll be presented with a very similar page to this one. And what we want to do here is to click add a DNS record. And in this specific case, it will be a CNAME, which is for subdomains. And the name here will be the name that you gave to the subdomain. In my case, it was simply gelato. And the value is what we copied. It was that value that appeared when before we clicked got it, just on that little pop-up window. And here on the TTL, you can leave the default. If you have any doubts about it, it's always best to contact the domain provider. We will leave it as that. And once it's ready, you just click add record. And there you go. It's here, already successful. And now let's go back to GetResponse. And this is where the boring part comes, is that you will have to wait for the changes to propagate through the DNS. As you can see, now it's pending here. It might take up to 24 hours, in some cases even 48. You just gotta wait a little and then it will be activated. As simple as that. As you can see, it's not something complicated, looks more complicated than it is. And I hope that with this video, I made it easy for you. It's time now for me to go, and I'll see you in the next video. Stay tuned.